In this video, we're going to show how to disassemble a Ruger Security 6 and how to assemble it again. So, start off by making sure the firearm is empty, it's functional, and we'll begin by taking off the grips. You can actually do this with a dime, so this is the only tool required. The idea being that Ruger Security 6 could be completely disassembled using just a dime in the field. Now the little pin was inside the handle there, fell out on the table. I'll show that to you later. That's necessary. It's included in with the grips. You can see that little hole over there it goes into. Now the next thing we're going to do is going to make use of that pin. Take the pressure off the hammer spring. You can start by first cocking back the hammer. That'll take the compress the spring, and then you just slide that little pin through there. And then when you lower the hammer, the spring is all loose in there. It just comes right out real easy. Now that little device that I just took out, that's also tool for further disassembly, so it's really kind of a neat idea. Okay, next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the hammer out. So with the hammer, just push through the little pins, and since there's no spring pressure against the hammer anymore, it comes out real easy. And then we just pull out that. You've got to pull the trigger back all the way to get that to get the hammer out. So I'll pull it all the way back. Wiggle it a little bit, and out she comes. Such a beautiful, simple design. Now we've got to take out the trigger assembly, and that is just a matter of, you've got to find this little button, and you'll see it just right. You see it right there at in that hole, and I'm just going to take. You can't see very well, but I'm taking that hammer spring, and I pressed against that button so that the whole trigger assembly comes out. Just a little spring-loaded pin. So with the trigger assembly out, you can take the cylinder out, and I'm holding the gun upside down because when you do that, there's a little piece that will fall out. But so first of all, see that, and take the little piece out that is loosely sitting in there. Just want to show you how that's oriented. So when you go to put the gun back together, you just have to lay that in there. Once you have it laid in, the little plunger there will press against the part of it, giving it upward pressure. Really quite simple. See, it just presses against there. Close the latch. Now we got that part done. Next we just put the trigger assembly back in. It's got a little bit of a notch there at the front. And there's that little pin that I compressed to take it apart. I'm just going to compress a little bit from behind just to get it started and give it good pressure. And she snaps back together. So next thing we do is we put the hammer back in. Slide that in. I'm holding the trigger back. Take a look at where the hole is. Get the right hole to line up so you can see here very quickly. There's that hole that I want the pin to line up through. The trigger pulled back. You can just set it right in there and take that pin and pop it back in. Hold the please barrel down as you test it out because there's no spring pressure to hold that hammer from falling out right now. So now we'll put the hammer spring back in. It's a loose assembly, so it fits in real easily. You can see the longer leg fits towards the front of the pistol. Once that's set in place, all you have to do is pull the hammer back. that little pin comes out, and now you got a fully functional revolver again. Just kind of cycle a little bit, make sure everything is running smooth. Then put your grips back together. So as you can see from this, I could have used a dime or some sort of coin to take the bolt out that's holding the grips together, and having done that, I could take the whole rest of the gun apart in the field or anywhere. So very simple, beautiful design. No wonder they sold so many of these guns.